This is going to be incredibly tough to call here. DRT is about as scary as you can get in CBT.
That is true, but there's a ton of games I haven't played in CBT lately, and he keeps using the same style. And
that is for
stopping because that it's he's going to use length of game. You have almost 100% chance.
He's facing a player 10 for a long period of time.
Absolutely.
And harassed like crazy. Our first map is going to be Daybreak. Map next, he performs quite well. And I feel like we have some sort of players who just check up the Broodlords every time instead of come at.
Yeah.
I feel like here to Jesus, he wins the player test.
Yeah. Well, I mean, we'll see if he can actually somehow make all three games here and possibly play Kasia in the next round. It's going to be difficult, but, you know, how do you really stop it? MKB tried last night to go back against him on Kingdom of Mana, and here he still crushed it.
Yeah.
It was 2-1. So,
all right, guys, looks like we're almost ready to do this. Let's get back here in Seoul, Korea, where the best StarCraft players in the world reside. These two right now, DRT, going up against Bulk. For our first game, the GS now.
In TVZ, it seems, and even TVP, and some TVPs. Command Center firsts are getting so popular because, you know what, even if you 6-4, there's a possibility of returning to hold.
Yeah.
And, I mean, if you're going to resetect X first, you're screwed. So, it's almost, like, completely easy to do.
Yeah.
So, most, putting up the lanes, we talked about you didn't get the throw
big that taint splash doesn't really affect things around them. It's a cool competition. But anyways, the button is Zerglings. Did he get chitinous plating? I think he did, actually. I think chitinous plating is all set for the Ultra Risks. We'll see if he puts on at some point. But pretty decent number of confessors up at 5.
We may see him actually just barrel in here towards the fourth control and just take him out. I'm not sure if Bulk can survive with this.
DRG, he does have 5 bases. Still, Bolt landed an orbital at that, the one that he lost before the original fourth, so he does have 5 as well. But the Brood Lords is what's going to be scary. When you're going 3 factories in which barriers,
I mean, Brood Lords are Vikings right now.
Well, he has only 1 starport, I think, because he only has 4 medevacs right now. I mean, he has not focused at all on flying units.
More legs of big Nautilus gearing up here.
Pretty good defense, as we see. Banelings and things in there, some supporters keep the medevacs away.
Looks like Bolt needs to push the bottom right, potentially the center.
This is a good time. Look at that Greater Spire. It's almost done. And draw the lead at the same time. This is a really good idea by Bolt. Let's see what he can actually get done.
Here, Gina, Trevor, Dennis, you're hitting that plant. We're going after sure this time.
That's right. And Bolt dropping out. Does he have enough? Other base, and with only 1 investor out, Bolt is a good spot.
DRG, but Bolton not done yet. Oh, note this, though. He's not actually minding that fourth pace. Looks like he should be minding that everywhere else.
Yeah, and notice he cannot make Zerglin. That is a big deal. But DRG's economy is so badly hurt at this point, it doesn't matter.
Wow, this is a very scrappy game. Very nice using these corruptors.
Well, you know what? Scrappy can beat that whole sport that he makes this year. He's a big game, a big hacker player. But if he gets scrappy for this whole game, he's worth so much. And that's exactly what he's doing here. He's drawing the medium-sized army at 1 minute and a half. These are things that Colt is really good at.
Good, but who's now against Bolton at first in the game?